Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. turn. Lost the 5 yards. Still second down.
Thank you.
41, Davey Silver in the ball carrier.
Thank you. Thank you. wanted but couldn't tame the Bears, this year the NFL brings two more of its star attractions to Wembley Stadium for the American Bowl 87. Colorado, last year's Super Bowl runners-up, the classy Denver Broncos. From California, the massive, intimidating Los Angeles Rams. If anyone doubted the hold American football has over the British public, it's here for all to see tonight. Yesterday, not even the cream of the world's soccer players, not even Diego Maradona, could fill this place. Tonight it's jam-packed for this imported phenomenon. The crowd limit was set at 80,000. The tickets were snapped up within days. Most of the spectators have been here for hours, soaking up the atmosphere. They came here for a fun night. They're determined to enjoy themselves. Stadium on this festive night. John Smith with me. John, quite an occasion.
It is. The excitement's just tremendous. It's not just a game anymore, it's a spectacle. It's really the only international event that the NFL has to showcase their game. And it's just tremendous for the British fans to see two of the top teams in the NFL here on their own turf.
What kind of a game is it going to be?
Well, it's one of five preseason games that these two teams will play. So we will see the stars, but we're also going to see a lot of young players trying to make it in the NFL. Their careers are at stake. They're fighting for their lives out here. So we should see a lot of spontaneity, a lot of good plays, and anything could happen.
Right. Now, because this is a preseason game, both teams will be using the majority of the 90 players that they have at the moment on their roster. Some, of course, are going to be cut. But each team does have one key player who will play an important role. Both will be on show tonight. The Broncos quarterback, John Elway, has developed after 4 years in the NFL into the coach's ideal playmaker. A passing arm that works like radar, he showed in the AFC Championship game against Cleveland that he can use it under the severest pressure.
He was the number one player taken in the 1983 college draft and was described as the perfect quarterback, big, strong, smart, tutored by his father, a college coach. He found it hard to live up to the billing the first year, but gradually established himself. And now he's the golden boy of the NFL. He led his team to the Super Bowl last year. He's a leader with great vision, versatility, and spontaneity. Defensive players hate to see him coming.
Eric Dickerson has been the spearhead of the Rams offense since he joined them 4 years ago. He's been the leading rusher in the NFL for three of the last 4 years, including last season when he carried the ball for over 1,800 yards and took the Rams into the playoffs.
Definitely the premier running back of the 1980s. First round choice in 1983. He's virtually the whole Rams offense. Teams plan their defense to stop Dickerson. Defensive players hate to go one-on-one with him. When he breaks into the backfield, he's unbeatable one-on-one. It usually takes two or three to bring him down.
Now those are the main protagonists. For those of you who need a refresher course on how the game works, here's John.
As we hold the action, Washington in red have the ball on their own 30-yard line, playing from left to right. Washington have four attempts, known as downs, to gain a total of at least 10 yards and retain possession. It's first and 10, their first attempt with 10 yards to go. Washington can move the ball by running with it or passing it. You can pass backwards or forwards. Let's see what happens. In fact, they run with it. The quarterback, Joe Theismann, hands the ball to running back John Riggins, who gains 4 yards before being tackled. A gain of 4 yards. Six left to go. Second down coming up. So it's second and six. Again, the Skins run the ball. Another gain of 4 yards by Riggins. So now 8 gained in total, 2 to go, but it's 3rd down, 3rd and 2. This time, Washington pops. Theismann drops back and prepares to throw. As his receivers set up downfield, let's consider the possible outcomes. 1, Washington catch the pass, the play is complete and they retain possession. 2, the opposition catch the ball, an interception, and they have possession. 3, no one catches the ball, the play is incomplete, Washington retain possession. No yards are gained or lost, but the down is wasted. Let's see what in fact happened. A perfect pass. Art Monk, the wide receiver, makes a good catch, and Washington have easily gained their 10 yards. They retain possession. Washington starts another series of 4 downs. They've moved to the opposition's 40-yard line and are in a scoring position. 1st and 10. Washington go for the pass immediately. Perfect again. Their tight end makes a clean catch and sprints into the end zone for a touchdown. 6 points. After a touchdown, an extra point can be added with a successful kick. Instead of going for a touchdown, a team will sometimes attempt a field goal worth 3 points.
Right, let's get on with the action. Our match commentators, NBC's Merlin Olsen and Dick Enberg.
Clifford Hicks, number 28. And Ron Brown, 89, deep to return for the Rams. Brian Wagner, a rookie from Cal State Northridge, to kick it off. It's to Hicks, the rookie from Oregon. 15, 20, and out to the 26-yard line. And this crowd, enthusiastic, colorful, exciting last year, seems even more so for this 87 encounter.
I think they have a little more knowledge about the game this year. They seem to be more responsive, but I think they also know more about the game.
You see the starters for the Rams, Everett at quarterback with Dickerson and Gooman, Brown and Henry Ellard with David Hill the tight end. We apologize for the loss of sound at the top of our program, so that part hasn't changed from last year. Everett over the middle, almost intercepted. It's caught by David Hill. Dennis Smith, number 49, had his hands on it, but Hill, the huge tight end for the Rams, able to out-wrestle the Bronco defender. Gilbert, Townsend, and Jones. You notice Andre Townsend moving from outside to the nose tackle. Jim Ryan, Carl Mecklenburg, Ricky Hundley, Ken Woodard. Woodard for the retired Tom Jackson. Mark Haynes for the surprising retirement of Louis Wright, Tony Lilly, Dennis Smith, and Mike Harden, the back four. Steve Foley, another retiree for Denver. 4 veterans leaving the club this year. Dickerson's first call nets him only a yard. Freddie Gilbert, number 90, there for the tackle.
Freddie Gilbert beefed up to 280 pounds. Moving in on that left end position, they've moved Rulon Jones over to the right end. He played right end before last year. Last year, of course, played left end. And they're really trying to do two things. They're trying to get into a defensive alignment that can play better against the run and also put more pressure on the quarterback without blitzing those linebackers.
3rd down and 4. Everett's first throw, no. They gobble him up at the 27-yard line. Andre Townsend, 61, along with number 77, Carl Mecklenburg.
Everett back to throw that football, but he's been trained. If it's not there, you're going to eat it. That's a sight we'll see often over the next weeks. Carl Mecklenburg, adept at getting on that quarterback's back.
Dale Hatcher, the veteran Ram putter, to Ricky Natiel. Natiel, 84, the top draft pick of the Broncos. They're in love with this young man from Florida. He fair catches it, and a difficult catch at the 38-yard line, and the Broncos will take over at that spot. Natiel has explosive speed and seems to catch everything in sight, what we've heard from the coaches and what we saw this week here in London. There's Elway with Winder and Lang, the backs that were behind him last year, Vance Johnson, the veteran Steve Watson, tight end Clarence Kay, recovering from some drug problems of last year. We'll get into that later. Stuttered Bishop, Brian Cooper, Lanier. the men in front of Elway. Just underway in London. 2.5 minutes gone in Elway's first offensive play. He's going long for Johnson, and a flag down. Jerry Gray, 25, the cornerback, bumping Vance Johnson. And we'll see if that's interference or the 5-yard preliminary hit. The flag dropped at the 34-yard line. There are the officials. And they, too, have enjoyed the experience of being here in London
contact
this week.
Number 25 defense, first down.
Illegal contact downfield out of that 5-yard zone. I think Gray a little concerned about the speed of Vance Johnson. With Nateel and Johnson and Jackson, the Denver Broncos have three receivers with blinding speed. That's going to scare any defense.
5-yard penalty and a first down. Reed, Meissner, and Miller, the starters on the front line. Kevin Green, a name to remember. He is a budding defensive star, joining that linebacking crew, Gray, Newsom, Cromwell, and Sutton. Sutton for Leroy Irvin. Sammy Winder darting to about the 48-yard line. Mark Giroux, 59, the tackler. Gain of about 5. It'll be second and 5.
Dick, success breeds success. It also, in the case of the Rams, breeds some contract problems. Leroy Irvin, unhappy with his contract for this year, had signed an extension for the next 2 years, and finally decided to practice, but has only had a couple of days of practice, and his coaches did not believe enough to put him into the game tonight, so he will not be on the field this evening.
Nicky Sutton, 49, playing at that right corner as the starter. Second and 5 for Elway. Gun to Watson through his hands. Again, the ball will be a bit slick. The grass is wet. It rained fairly hard for about 45 minutes at 4 o'clock this afternoon.
Ball may have been tapped, too. It may have been touched by Sean Miller on the right-hand side. Watson adjusts to the ball as he goes downfield, but then the ball just seemed to take off. Here he is, and there just, I think it had been tapped. It was, it looked like a Frisbee coming out there.
Third down and 5. Watson, who is the slowest of the Denver Bronco receiving core, and that's only because they have just absolute blazing speed in Johnson, Jackson, and Nateel. Third and 5 for Elway. Under pressure, gets away for a moment. Doug Reed finishes the job, number 93. It was Kevin Green applying the early pressure. Elway eluded him, but on came Reed, the 4-year man from San Diego State.
Elway, more adept, I think, than any quarterback in the league at escaping pressure, could not escape a horde of Ram tacklers. And Green, who does the same job for the Rams that Mecklenburg does for the Broncos, was the first man to pull him down, and then Reed was there to put the baggie together on him.
So both quarterbacks taste the turf here at Wembley on a third down pass attempt. This is Wagner, who kicked off for the Broncos, to Clifford Hicks.
Woo.
At the 20-yard line and hit immediately. The Rams will start from around their own 20. Dickerson could care less as he rambles for 11, maybe 12 yards before he's tripped up by Dennis Smith.
Dick, it was interesting before the game. The biggest rounds of applause, obviously, for this man, Eric Dickerson, finest runner in professional football. And, well, we say that with apologies to Walter Payton, but Dickerson has led in 3 out of the last 4 years. And, of course, the other man that received the applause, John Elway.
Over the middle and through the hands of Mike Gooman, well covered by Jim Ryan. Ryan, the 9-year veteran from William and Mary. Second and 10 for the Rams at their own 33-yard line. No score. 10 minutes and 16 seconds remaining in this first period. It will be up to the coaches, but they both estimated that the first line players will play about a quarter and a half. Dickerson, little delay. Oh, look at the power of the man as he crosses the 40-yard line and a gain of 7.
I asked Eric Dickerson if he'd thought about how long he'd like to play in the NFL. He said, well, I think about 10, 11 years. Well, that's a long life for a running back, but his unusual style, he's a punishing runner, and yet he rarely takes those straight-on hits. He has a way of shifting his body and delivering those blows, but I tell you, when you carry the ball as many times as he has over the last 4 years, it's got to take its toll on you.
More than anyone has ever carried the ball in his first 4 years in the NFL. Third and three. Everett has a first down across the 45 to the 46-yard line. Tony Lilly there, number 22 for the Broncos.
We've talked about the Rams' emphasis on the passing game. A new offensive coordinator, Ernie Zampezi. And, of course, this new quarterback, really in his first training camp, came in from Houston, would not sign with the Oilers. The Rams put him to work for the latter part of the season, but he really is still a learning young quarterback.
First down at the 46-and-a-half. Ellard and Brown, the speed to the left. It's Dickerson running right and a flag down as Dickerson reaches the 50-yard line. Ryan again in on the tackle for Denver. And thrown by the linesman where we'd suspect just that, offside Rams.
But, Dick, if there is a perfect situation for a young quarterback,
offside.
It's right behind the running of Eric Dickerson.
Now that'll make you a better passer.
Oh, boy, will it ever.
From play one.
Will it ever.
8:30 remaining in a scoreless first period. The ball at the 41-yard line. Los Angeles Rams possession. First down and 15 after the offside penalty. A screen to Dickerson. This is the play they're working on. He's at the 50 into the Denver 49. Gain of 9 yards, maybe 10 for Dickerson. Oh, that's frightening to give him that kind of room. And, of course, Chuck Muncy was that back in the San Diego offense.
Well, what they're doing is spreading the defense. They're forcing the defensive backs off. The linebackers are off, looking pass. And then Dickerson just swings to the outside. Little screen. They've tried to give him room. Fine block out there. Tony Slayton, I believe, 61. Maybe Duval Love. Hard to see. No, it was Newberry. Newberry. Tom Newberry.
Whoops, a little confusion there. The man that hit Dickerson first was his quarterback. And short yardage the result, maybe a yard or two, call it the 48-yard line, and that'll bring up third down and four.
We're going to see some rust from these two offenses. It takes a longer period of time to get those offensive units together. The defense is at this point in training camp always a little bit ahead of the offenses. Really only takes one guy to mess up a play, and if you don't have all 11 guys working correctly and together on offense, it's not going to work.
Whereas a defensive player, even if he does something crazy, can
sometimes
make the play.
Sometimes it destroys the play. Exactly right.
Everett looking for the first down yard. Oh! Oh, Mike Harton, who intercepted two for touchdowns last year, had 6 points in his grasp.
We talked about some of the changes in this defensive secondary for the Denver Broncos. Losing Steve Foley and Louis Wright was a great loss, not only in terms of performance, but also in leadership. Mike Harton is the man they're counting on to take over the leadership responsibilities in that secondary. And gosh, he could have had a free track all the way into the end zone, I think, on that one.
Hatcher to kick, number 35. Ken Bell is back for Denver.
Oh, that's out of the stadium.
Fair catch for Bell at the 9-yard line. For another fine punt, unreturnable. Broncos start deep in their own end. Timeout, 6 minutes, 50 seconds left in the first period. Typical of the European football stadia, a large standing room section at both end zones. And we would say that about half the crowd is standing of the over 80,000 for this sellout late evening on this Sunday night in London. No score. Elway sets up at his own 9-yard line. Lang and Winder behind him. Watson in motion.
You know what?
Oh! Crushed in his own backfield as Sammy Winder is charging through for the Los Angeles Rams.
Sean Miller from his right end position. Miller has been a nose tackle and a left end in the last year or so. Now he's over right end. Boy, he burst through there. And of course, you want to have someone with real quickness at that right end position. And Miller showing you a lot of that. Utah Stater had three tackles in this game, Dick.
Sean Miller,
one
fourth year for the Rams.
Rulon Jones is an athlete. Greg Craig in a tackle, Sean Miller in end, and Roland Jones in end.
We're still about an hour and a half.
Second down and
13. It's a different standing up here for these 3 hours.
His own end zone, Elway. Underneath to Winder, incomplete. Ball jarred free as Mark Giroux played his college ball at Washington, number 59. Made the play defensively. Giroux took over last year at that linebacker spot when Jim Collins, a Pro Bowler the year before, missed the entire year with shoulder that just would not respond. He just had total numbness, no feeling, nerve damage in that shoulder. But Collins apparently is back and healthy, and the Rams are very excited by the strength now built in that linebacking core.
Just the standings?
Three receivers to the left for Elway out of the shotgun on third and long. Clarence Kay split right. Flags down. Elway doing what he does so well, scrambling and then out of bounds at the 9. Flag down. Gain of 3 if it counts. Penalty is against the Broncos. Rams undoubtedly will decline and take the football as the 3-yard gain would bring up 4th and 10.
There's 20,000 seats, 20,000 these on each end, right? 26,000 standings on each end. Okay.
Apparently an illegal formation. Too many people off of the line. Steve Watson, the man that they're ticketing for not being up on the line. Not enough people on the line of scrimmage.
You have to have at least 7. You can have more than that. But with the 3 men to the left and K to the right, all 4 of those wide receivers were off the line. Wagner trying to make the squad as a kickoff man and punter. Mike Moran is injured, will not kick
blocking
today. And a good boot that'll come down to about the 46 of the Rams. Picks 45 and out of bounds at the Denver 44, maybe the 43. Third picks hit by Tony Lilly. Picks the number 3 draft pick of the Rams. Wembley Stadium, back in the 1920s when they hosted the World Exposition, those domes above the roof line, part of the tribute to the country of India. Wembley in 48, of course, there they are, a pair. In the 48 Olympics, that was Fanny Blankers-Cohen of the Netherlands, who won 4 gold medals, and a teenager from California, Bob Mathias, the decathlon winner for the U.S.
That was before my time.
The Rams in Bronco territory, and it's Eric Dickerson inside the 40-yard line to about the 37. Andre Townsend tripping him up from behind. So for the first time, one of the teams in opponent's territory. 5 minutes left in this first period, no score.
Okay.
Really a game dominated by some inept offense and some aggressive defense. And as we said, the defensive team's ahead of the game this early in the season. Rams may have something going here.
Second and 3 for Everett. He threw that one away as Carl Mecklenburg had Dickerson well covered. Well, let's see who Ahmad Rashad is covering.
All right. Taking on the United States, they have what they call the end zone seats, which are usually the worst seats in the house. But here, they go a step farther. These are the end zone standing. There's 26,000 of these on each end of the field. Now people come here and they watch soccer, which usually lasts about an hour and a half, but a football game goes 3 hours. I'll check back later and see how these people are making it in the fourth quarter.
That's right. It comes as a surprise to the British, who on television see an edited version of this game and last year didn't realize it would last quite so long. Henry Ellard with a grab and may have a first down at the 33-yard line. Ellard is a key to this Ram offense. Zampezi feels he could be the Rams' Wes Chandler. He says Ellard, if everything goes well, should catch 70 balls, about 1,200 yards, and 10 touchdowns.
Hello there, everybody.
Of course, he's had contract problems with the Rams. Held out a good part of last season. But when he did come in and worked with Jim Everett, there was a very quick relationship established between the two of them, and I think he's Everett's favorite receiver.
Heisman winner Charles White from Southern California, the ball carrier. White backing up Eric Dickerson down at the 32. Tony Lilly, number 22, from Florida in his fourth year with the Broncos. White and the rest of the backs beside Dickerson. Robinson says, frankly, if they gain 400 yards, that's about all we expect from them. They're in there to block for Eric.
You've got that horse. You've got to give him a chance to play.
Are you cold yet?
White. We've seen him make some great runs. A Rose Bowl game where he was a whole show in himself.
Dick. Set the record, 247 yards, 1980, against Ohio State. Everett has a man open. And a first down inside the 20. Mike Harden on the coverage.
That'll brighten things up. Again, I mentioned the relationship between Ellard and Jim Everett. He just sends him down and out. And one thing Everett has, he hasn't yet developed all the subtle skills of an experienced quarterback, but he is getting better and better at throwing the passes he has to throw to settle into the passing game. That's that little down and out to Ellard, and well executed.
Everett now going to Kevin House. It's complete at the 6-yard line. Make it the 5. House, who played at Tampa Bay, acquired on waivers by the Rams late last year and delivered some big plays.
John Robinson talked about improving the passing environment, not just the passing game, the environment. That means protection for throwing the football and catching the football. So far, they have to be pleased at what they're seeing.
The numbers on House, the 25-yard average, of course, those 7 catches after he left Tampa Bay. Those are just his Rams numbers of 86. First and goal for the Rams, just inside the 5, and Dickerson outside, using his power, using his speed. Six-three and 220 pounds, Eric Dickerson. You just isolate him on 2 Bronco defenders, and he can beat you 1 against 2.
Well, Mark Kane's had a shot at him, but simply was pushed out of the way. I think Eric just straight-armed him. But as you said, Dick, he just used his power and his speed on that play. A good illustration of both as he put it in the end zone.
Mike Lansford to try the point after. Steve Dills, number 8, the holder. And the Los Angeles Rams have the early lead here at Wembley Stadium in London. 2 minutes and 9 seconds remaining in the opening quarter. Eric Dickerson from Everett, 4 yards for the touchdown.
And here we go. Watch the straight arm right there. Just pushed Haynes to the ground. Lilly had a shot at him too, but Eric, using those big, powerful legs and some upper body strength that's not bad itself, to push his way into the end zone.
Well, the Rams, who made it to the playoffs in the 4 years with Dickerson's running, but that drive really culminated by Dickerson, but it was the throwing of Everett to both Ellard and House that set up the score.
And there's no question, if they can get the passing game going, they'll take the heat off of Dickerson and also make him even more effective.
Wait, there's Paul Thornburn, signed by the Rams for this game. He's a Welsh national rugby player, a fullback. It's a thrill for him. Thornburn to kick off. It's a little shy to the 22. Taken there by Jim Ryan. Ryan, the linebacker, out to the 32-yard line. Well, Thornburn is not going to make the million-dollar contract on boots like that.
He certainly was excited. I was out at the Ram practice when he was signing his contract, and he was a very nervous young man as he was inking the bottom line of that contract.
What do you think the bonus was?
Well, I saw the numbers. There's 70,000 on the contract. That wasn't bad.
What? 70,000 what?
Oh, those were dollars, I think.
Trailing 7-0, the Broncos with 1:39 left in the first period. Elway, incomplete. Ooh. Nolan Cromwell breaking up the pass intended for the tight end, Clarence Kay.
Some delightful contrasts in this game. These two defensive teams, for example, really at opposite extremes in terms of complexity. The Rams talk about their pure vanilla defense. In fact, I talked to Fritz Schirmer, the defensive coordinator. I said, well, Fritz, did you put the whole offense in the first, or the defense in the first day? He said, yep. Got it, yeah.
As simple as you can make it.
Well, they just line up and challenge you man-to-man, head-to-head, and they do it very well.
Bell and Lang now behind Elway. Watson in motion. Elway spinning out of trouble. Downfield to Kane. Completed the 50. They love it in England. Yards, and Elway, leading quarterback runner in the last 3 years in the NFL. He bought the time.
Ahmad Rashad will remember this. Watch this Tarkenton roll. Elway rolling opposite, back against the grain as he rolled out behind, and then finding a little space out there, spotted the open man and got him the football. Clarence Kay, by the way, since he's come back this year, is they're leaving him out on third downs. They didn't do that last year. Moved him out on third downs.
Yeah, that's testimony how far he's come back.
He's really made progress.
First down at midfield. And a whistle blows that one dead before it can get going.
If we can get a shot of Clarence later on when he has his helmet off, he shaved his head. He said, that's my American bowl look.
5 yards on the procedure against the Broncos. First and 15 from the 45. The fans appreciating Elway's skill, a big man, 6'3", 210 pounds, not only with that rifle arm, but the fact that he has such a great sense of where the defensive pressure is in that pocket, knowing just when to roll and what direction to go. And they have a couple of plays set up off that roll by Elway that could result in some spectacular scores. Elway. Oh, a sliding catch for about 8 yards to Vance Johnson, the speedster from Arizona, who had a big Super Bowl. Cromwell on the coverage.
Johnson, of course, hurt very early last year. Really a big game in the early part of the year and a big game late in the year. Not much in between.
1.5-point underdogs. Wagering is very legal in this country. Elway can't find an orange shirt. There's one. The tight end, Kay, and Mike Wilcher, number 54 from North Carolina, drills him at the 43.
One of the things that John Robinson wants his defensive team to do this year is to put more pressure on the quarterbacks. And right there you saw the result of allowing Elway too much time. One of the reasons that they've had a little trouble doing that, they really don't like to blitz. They send those down linemen, but they don't like to blitz the linebackers. They like to keep them in pass coverage.
Broncos in Rams territory for the first time. It's third down, a long two. Kay, the tight end, being moved to the right side. Down the middle, complete, good catch at the 37-yard line and a first down. It went to number 30, Steve Sewell. They're all-purpose running back and receiver.
Looking in over the shoulder of Carl Eckern, his linebacking position. You'll see Eckern on the left-hand side of your picture. He's the man responsible for Sewell, but they're a fraction late. You're absolutely right. Sewell doing a good job of hanging onto that football. Eckern trying to strip it away. First and 10.
7-0 Rams, early second quarter. Wembley Stadium sold out again this year. Over 80,000 to see these two top NFL teams. Lang in motion. Elway drills it. Incomplete. Might have been deflected. It was intended for Vance Johnson, and Mickey Sutton there for Los Angeles, number 49. He's there in place of Leroy Urban.
Number 82, Vance Johnson, an exciting player. Very explosive, very quick off the ball. He's going to try to get himself some room down there, but I think you're right. I think Wilshire may have touched that football. Certainly came at an odd angle. Trying to run the man off with his speed, Mickey Sutton. Yeah. Not supposed to touch him, Mickey, until the ball arrives.
Second down and 10. Winder and Lang behind Elway. In traffic, Elway tries to scramble, and Doug Reed, number 93, stopping the Bronco quarterback from really going into a gallop. He's down to the 36-yard line, where it'll be third down and 8.5.
Did he get him behind the line, or did he make a little yardage?
He made a couple of yards.
No sack on that. Reed would have had his second sack of the day had Elway gone down behind the line of scrimmage. Dan Reese has to be a little discouraged that his offense has not been more explosive and productive here early in this ballgame.
Dan Reeves very nearly was a Los Angeles Ram out of South Carolina. It's a story, if we have time, we'll share with you. Elway, this is one of those plays, and open is Watson. The incomplete, broken up by Jerry Gray. as the ball hit the ground. That's one of those planned scrambles to the left, and then Watson cutting across the middle, stopping, and then angling to the far side. Only a man with an arm like Elway can even consider a pass like that.
That's a transcontinental pass. Elway is designed to scramble to the outside, as you said. Watson tries to drive his man inside, but look at the reactions of number 25, Jerry Gray. He's not going to have any of that. In fact, came very close to intercepting that ball. He has it there. It's a scramble. Ball ends up rolling loose. Neither of them had it, but that is a dangerous pass. It's in the air so long, and you're right. Most quarterbacks and most coaches in the league won't call that play.
5 yards against the Broncos for delay of game. Now, that'll give us a chance to underline one of the changes, at least in the preseason, an experimental rule by the NFL, a 40-second clock rather than a 30. The 40 being as soon as the ball is marked dead. They start a 40-second clock rather than waiting, say, on an incomplete pass to bring the ball all the way back, mark it, and then start a 30-second clock. So it's a 40-second clock being used for the first 3 preseason games. Then they'll decide whether or not it works in the regular year. Wagner, after the penalty, will deliver from around the 50-yard line. Johnny Johnson deep for the Rams, the veteran safety. And it will go out of bounds. Oh, a good kick inside the 5. Brian Wagner, Cal State Northridge, trying to win a job, does a good job on that punt inside the 5. With Merlin Olsen, Dick Kenberg, and Ahmad Rashad with the crowd here at Wembley Stadium. The Rams lead the Broncos 7-0, and on first down, Charles White manages just a yard against a second unit defense of the Broncos. That was number 38, Bruce Plummer, 9th round pick from Mississippi State, that made the tackle.
What's your name?
Bill.
2 yards for White on the play. It's second down and 8. The Rams scoring on a Dickerson run of 4. He's not in there, but the rest of the first unit is. Charles White, a tailback. Ellard right, Brown, the Olympic sprinter, to the left. Everett looking over the middle, has Ellard, incomplete at the 25. Broken up by Tyrone Braxton, 34, a rookie. Let's go to a veteran, Ahmad Rashad.
All right. Now, I know all of you out there have heard of Broncomania, but I bet you didn't know it came all the way over here to England. And I've got you. Now, tell me now, how'd you get caught up in this Broncomania?
Well, and John Elway is the greatest footballer, and we've just got to...
No. Tell me about the Super Bowl last year. That's what I want to ask you.
Super Bowl? Oh, that's so disappointing. We should have won. We should have won. It was incredible. I was up till 4 o'clock, 4 a.m. in the morning, 3 a.m. watching.
All right. Let's watch the play. We'll be right back.
Everett just eluding a safety and now scrambles out of bounds at the 12-yard line. It'll be short of a first down. Number 99, Raymond Woodard of Texas, almost had 2 points for the Broncos. Interesting in that chap with Ahmad Rashad. Elway's his favorite, but he wears Steve Watson.
Well, maybe that's the only jersey he get his hands on.
I guess all the 7s were sold out.
Yeah.
Look how close Everett came from being dumped in his own end zone.
But a safety, obviously. He's glad to escape that. And smart to get out of bounds. Another step or so, and he's going to be leveled.
Well, the Broncos, nevertheless, will come up with good field position. Ricky Natiel back at the 45. He's a dangerous kick returner. Hatcher's kick's a beauty. Natiel, the rookie from Florida, at the 43. 45-50. 45-40. Ricky Natiel, you're going to see a lot of him in Denver this year. 5'9", 180 pounds. And Dale Hatcher was in on the tackle along with John Embry. 45-yard punt by Hatcher, a 22-yard return by that man, Natiel, who was a high school quarterback before entering University of Florida.
A lot of people surprised when Dan Reeves and the Broncos staff took this man on their first available choice, but they just said we couldn't leave him. He has too much talent. He's the exciting kind of player that can help us, and although we have some speed receivers already, many people expected them to go after the big down running back.
First down play goes to Ken Bell, a second-year man from Boston College, a quick hitter from quarterback John Elway into the 29-yard line. Gary Kubiak has replaced Elway at quarterback, and it was Kubiak on that throw as he completes his first toss.
I think we'll see a little more of Elway later in this quarter.
Or to start the second half.
Yes, and also to start the second half. But for the moment, Kubiak is in to handle responsibility.
Solid backup. He's done a good job whenever called upon. Second and two inside the 30. It's Sewell from Oklahoma around the corner and dumped after a first down at the 24. Mickey Sutton made the tackle. Let's go to Ahmad Rashad.
All right, Dick, I'm still here with Bill Grove, see, because he hasn't quite explained to me what happened to the Broncos last year in the Super Bowl.
We were robbed.
You were robbed?
Yes, we should have gone for a pass on them two 1 yard line situations.
Yeah, yeah.
And instead of trying three running plays.
That happens, man.
And we'd have
I played on the Vikings. We lost four times. We were robbed,
you
too.
You played on the Vikings?
Dick?
You played.
Did you really play on the Vikings, Ahmad?
That might be a continuing discussion. A little reverse, and it goes to Mark Jackson, and he's out of bounds at the 25, maybe the 24. Mike Wilcher not fooled by the reverse play.
Rams not buying any of that. A moment ago, you saw Steve Sewell doing what Dan Reeves thinks he's going to be able to do more of this year. He's beefed himself up to about 210 pounds. They're hoping that he can take some of the load at that running back position. And he looked like he is a load when he was coming around on that running play.
Well, with Winder and Lang, they look like they could wear the same uniform, 5'10", 5'11", around 200 pounds. They're looking for a little bigger back to improve that running game. Sewell is bigger, and rookie Warren Marshall from James Madison University is a 216-pounder. We'll see him later. Kubiak didn't like what he saw, has called time. 9 minutes, 25 seconds remaining in the first half. Second and 11 deep in Ram territory. Kubiak deflected at the line of scrimmage. He was trying to hit Ricky Natiel. I believe it was Mark Giroux who had the coverage, and one of the defensive linemen, could have been Doss, 71, got a big hand up. So that'll bring up third and 11 for Kubiak, who played his college ball at Texas A&M, now in his fifth year with the Broncos. He, like Elway, drafted in the 1983 rounds, only he was picked 197 spots after Elway.
He's been a good one. A good one.
Eric Dickerson, also part of that 83 draft. Ooh, deflected out of the hands of Steve Sewell by 51. Norwood Van from East Carolina. Rich Carlos going to come on and try a field goal for Denver.
We saw a lot of Steve Sewell at the H-back position last year, coming in motion. This particular play, look at that. Fine defensive play. Van stretching with that outside hand, reaching across in front to deflect that football. Ball would have been caught otherwise. Well thrown by Kubiak.
Rich Carlos, who kicked the Broncos into the Super Bowl with a 33-yarder in overtime against the Cleveland Browns. That'll be long remembered by both cities. Drills a long high attempt, and it is good. Rich Carlos easily from 41 yards out, and the Broncos are on the board. Just under 9 minutes left in the opening half. Rams 7. Denver 3. After the field goal, the kickoff comes down to Clifford Hicks of the Rams, and the former Oregon Duck returns to the 21-yard line. Darren Como was the special team star for the Broncos, 59 last year, in on another hit. First down, Los Angeles, and let's see the changes that John Robinson makes. There's Robinson, who you've admired his relationship with the athlete, have you not, Merle?
Well, I really have. I don't know of a coach in the NFL who has more respect from his players than John Robinson, and I like him. I really like the man. I think he's a straight shooter.
Charles White on the sweep has 5-6 yards, maybe 7 before rookie Dallas Cameron from Miami of Florida can make the tackle. Robinson told us prior to this game that those are his top priorities. Improve the passing game, and that's obvious, getting Zampezi from San Diego. He engineered that Dan Fouts run offense. 6 out of 8 years best in the NFL. Improved the pass rush. He didn't like the fact that the sack total was down in the 30s last year. And he wants to return the special teams back to number one where they were a couple of years ago. And there was a fourth. He says Eric Dickerson has to cut his fumbles in half. Long throw by Everett. He's got a man in the clear. Ron Brown. Incomplete at the 30-yard line. Well, you'll see Ron Brown again later on NBC Sports World. He's one of the competitors in the NFL's fastest man contest out in Palm Desert, California. Believe it or not, Ahmad Rashad, never known for his speed, is going to make it from London out to the desert of California.
Well, you've got to be fast to do that. Vance Johnson is in that competition, too.
Vance Johnson of the Denver Broncos. Phillips of Green Bay. The defending champion, Darrell Green, of the Washington Redskins, injured, was unable to defend his title. Third down and 4 for Everett. Over the middle, complete to Ellard, and a first down just shy of the 40-yard line. Let's check the numbers. They get up. Ron Brown it was. Brown going on a long sprint downfield and then just a little curl underneath. Bruce Plummer, a rookie defender, made the tackle. And a first down for Los Angeles. Well, the passing game has looked good. First catch for Brown. This is White, a little misdirection. And he's toppled. A flag is down as well. Tyrone Braxton up from the secondary to make the hit. He's from North Dakota State, a 12th round draft pick, number 34. Flipping is the call against the Rams, and that'll send them back. The Rams have a difficult situation because of this game. They'll fly home tonight, get into California early in the morning. Little trouble. Well, part of Tom Dooley's call. And then have to play at home against Seattle Thursday night. So they have little time to recover nor practice before playing again.
I think that's a dangerous situation. That's certainly something that they're going to have to try and correct in the future, not to stagger a couple of games that close together for a team that'll be fighting all that jet lag. The thing I'd be worried about is players who aren't alert, can't be alert, getting hurt in that game. And I'm sure that's John Robinson's concern.
First down and long for Everett. What a catch by David Hill, the big tight end. He's listed at 6'2 and 235.
I don't believe that.
That's 30 pounds within 30.
David Hill, not known for his pass-catching abilities, at least not in recent years for the Rams. More of a blocker, but he's the emergency receiver picked out by Everett here. And you see there how quick Everett can get that ball off when he wants to. He has an unusual throwing motion, kind of just swinging that ball out on the side. But he is making real progress as a passer.
Out to the 31-yard line, where it'll be a second and 18. Draw play to White. Skips away from Robbins, but has to give ground. And lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. Randy Robbins, 48, came up to force the play wide. Steve Wilson, the veteran from Howard University, number 45, finally got him out of bounds, along with Simon Fletcher, 73.
Simon Fletcher, an interesting story, has been a down lineman. They've moved him back to linebacking position this year. Want to give him a chance to cut his teeth there. Can you imagine what it would look like if they had Simon Fletcher, 6'5" and 260 pounds on one side, Mecklenburg on the other? You got to pick one or the other to go after. Oof.
Third down and long. Everett goes underneath the Hill, the tight end, 40, and tripped up at the 42-yard line. That'll be about 8 shy of a first down. Rookie Darrell Russell, free agent from Appalachian State, made the tackle. So the second line, even the third line, Denver defense played very well in that drive, stopping basically a first team offensive unit of the Rams. And into punt is Dale Hatcher. Ken Bell back at the 20 for Denver. Rams leading 7-3, 5 minutes, 35 seconds left in the first half. Beautiful spiral. Oh, my, is that a beauty. Bell inside the 10. And smothered at the 12 or 13.
The key to that punt was hang time. When you put it that high, you give your coverage people a chance to get down underneath it. Hatcher showing the form that got him in the Pro Bowl in his rookie year.
50 yards on that one. A 3-yard return there. You see Leroy Irvin, 47, out of uniform except for the jersey. Well, I wonder what's happening with Ahmad Rashad.
Dick, you know, these fans are not only just fans, they're very knowledgeable. Now, Bill told me earlier that the Broncos were robbed in the Super Bowl. What do they have to do this year to get back to the Super Bowl?
Just play the same as they did last year, and they'll be there.
Yeah, but how about winning it this time?
They will win this season. They will win.
There have been some teams that have not won, and here's one of them right here, but my man's still proud of it anyway, aren't you?
Yeah, great.
All right, go Vikes.
A man of select words. You notice he got a Viking guy, though.
You're drawing a real crowd down there, Ahmad.
6 yards on that opening play for the Broncos. It'll be second down and 4 at their own 20-yard line. Jackson to the left, Nateel to the right. Gary Kubiak at quarterback. Over the middle to Joey Hackett, 25, 30, 33, and Hackett is a big load to bring down. 6'5 and 267 from Elon of North Carolina. He's as big as the school.
Well, I tell you, he is a horse. Younger brother Dino, a linebacker in Kansas City. Carl Eckern, a man who's going to try and gather him up. Eckern with a fine year last year, selected to the Pro Bowl for his first time. Quick response, but that's just trying to flag down a truck. He's got a piece of him, but away he went.
First down on the pass play to the 32-yard line. 3:57 remaining in the first half. Kubiak underneath again to Bell, and Mark Giroux there immediately. Giroux, an academic All-American at Washington. A student, John Elway now helping Dan Reeves with the signal making from the sidelines. There are Reeves' priorities this year, improving that running game. He wants to get that average up into the fours, and he wants to be better against the run. And he was a little disappointed last year in the two-minute defense. He felt he gave up too many points late in the first and second half.
Well, I think, too, he wants to make sure they don't give up as many points as they did late in the season last year. They had some defensive problems.
Second down and 8. Draw play, and there's a hole for Bell. 40, 45. He's all the way to the 49. Eckern brings him down along with Norwood Van and Michael Stewart, a rookie, but 18 yards for Bell on the play.
It's interesting that Ken Bell, of course, one of the people that is going to get a good look. Denver, when they couldn't find the big running back they wanted in the draft, they said, well, let's give the people we have here another shot, and let's give them all the help we can give them. So far, Ken Bell has looked good. Steve Sewell has looked good.
There's another youngster, Joe Dudek, from Plymouth State that they like, and he'll be battling Bell for a spot on the roster. Nothing that time for Sewell except Mark Giroux, number 59.
These two teams worked against each other 3 days during the week, practiced against each other, had scrimmages. Some very emotional, hard-hitting scrimmages, actually, particularly with the younger players. And I think had they not done that, had they tried to work out on their own since they'd gone to one-a-days over here instead of a two-a-day practice as they would have at home, they might have lost some ground. But I think by working against the other team, they pumped the emotion into those practices and got a lot out of them.
Approaching the two-minute warning, they may not get the play off, and they do not. There is the whistle. No play. The two-minute timeout. Here at Wembley Stadium, where the British wave is in evidence. The score, the Los Angeles Rams 7, the Denver Broncos 3. John Elway returns to the Bronco lineup in this two-minute drill. That's one of the things Dan Reeves hoped that he would have in this game, giving Elway a chance in the two-minute. It's a screen, and he has blocker Steve Sewell. But breaking through that wedge was 93 Doug Reed, who's played an outstanding first half defensively for the Rams. Reed from San Diego State, the man who replaced one of the Ram immortals, Jack Youngblood, a couple of years ago. Youngblood now in the front office of the Los Angeles Rams.
Kevin Green in quickly to pressure Elway. And I think Elway had to unload that screen a little bit sooner than he wanted to, maybe making it possible to read it. Usually the defensive lineman that penetrated further by the time he get that ball off.
Third down, a short 8. Elway, a little pitch to Sewell at the 40, 35, open field. Steve Sewell to the 23-yard line, and a first down Denver. Well, in essence, it's the draw play out of the shotgun, the little toss forward to Sewell.
A little shovel pass. We remember this one. The Dallas Cowboys ran it effectively for a number of years. Sewell starting across inside. Watch the defensive end. The trick is to pull the defensive end in, make it look like a pass, and then trap him. They didn't even have to trap him. He's so far, Evans so far upfield that Sewell had an open path. They were able to just run the lineman upfield, give him an extra blocker, and he picked up excellent yardage.
Well, John Robinson had his top draft pick, Donald Evans, 64. He was the man slickered by the play, and Evans perhaps didn't have that same kind of training at Winston-Salem State. Elway to Wilhite, Gerald Wilhite, and he gets out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Kevin Green helped him measurably. No gain. Well, they corrected the clock. It was down under a minute and now reset, and there's exactly a minute remaining at the moment. Merlin, I know you want to join all of us in congratulating the inductees that join you in the Pro Football Hall of Fame, our former colleague Lenny Dawson, Larry Zonka, Joe Green, John Henry Johnson, Jim Langer, Don Maynard, and Gene Upshaw, inducted yesterday in Canton, Ohio.
Well, I know the feeling, and I know how excited they were yesterday. It's still probably glowing through them right now.
Elway looking long. Watson can't hang on at the 5-yard line, broken up. Number 23, Michael Stewart, a 8th-round draft pick from Fresno State, making a tough play against a talented veteran receiver, Watson.
The other thing that made that catch difficult was the fact that Jerry Gray went up so high, kind of blocked Watson's view of the ball as it came over the top.
Third down and 10 for the Broncos at the 23-yard line. They trail by 4, 7-3. Watson, Jackson to the right. Vance Johnson is split to the left. 10th play of this drive. Elway, little roll, plenty of protection. Throws cross field to Sewell. Sewell inside the 20, but not enough for a first down. Stopped at the 18. Stewart, along with Norwood Van. Eckern there as well for the Rams. So Carlos will not come on here, but they will go for the field goal. Mike Clendenin will try it for the Broncos. An apparent field goal attempt, we should say.
Clendenin, a barefoot kicker, as is the Ram kicker, Mike Lansford.
It will be a 35-yard attempt by Clendenin. He spins it through. Didn't have a lot of distance, but enough to get 3 for the Broncos. So Clendenin on the board for his first pro field goal. Not totally happy with the kick. He got under it a little too much, a little fat, but it's good enough for a Denver 3.
That thing was rotating a mile a minute. A real chip shot. Watch how far he goes underneath this ball. Kicks it high in the air. Just touches the edge of that goalpost, but hey, it's 3 points.
So plenty for the Wembley crowd to respond to, and I hope some moments for you at home. The Rams in front at halftime by 1. John, what did you make of that first half?
Well, it's a typical preseason game where the defense comes out and dominates. The offense a little bit rusty because it takes a while for the offense to get that coordination between the quarterback and the receivers and get everything ticking. But we've seen a lot of our stars out there. We've seen some good play, and I think we'll see more in the second half.
Right, let's talk about those stars. First of all, we had Dickerson's run, touchdown run, but it follows some passing, which is a new element for the Rams.
That's right, their quarterback, Everett, they've never had a quarterback who could spark the team. And he came out with 3 nice passes in that drive, a 5-yard pass, a 13, a 15, got them rolling, gave the ball to Dickerson on the 4-yard line, and Dickerson did the rest. Nobody can stop Dickerson from inside that 5-yard line. He just roared into the end zone, which is Dickerson's style.
And as if he was hurt by the attention that Dickerson was getting, Elway responded immediately, breaking out of the pocket.
He did. Elway's strength is coming out of that pocket and improvising. He just rolled out, the defense ran after him, and he made things happen and threw the ball across the middle. He's one of the few quarterbacks that can throw the ball across the field from one side to the other. He has the strength to just zing the ball in there and not give the defense a chance to recover. And he's exciting to watch. Every time he rolls out of that pocket, I get goosebumps. He's just so exciting.
So how's the second half going to go?
Well, I'm going to make a tip. I think the Rams are going to win. The Rams drafted 5 defensive players, the first five picks this year. And so I think defense is going to predominate when all the rookies get in the second half. Because again, the coordination for offense is more difficult. So I think the Rams will take over on defense.
And with the rookies on, we may not get such outstanding plays, but very competitive.
It'll be competitive, but we'll see some surprise plays maybe, because there'll be mistakes. And when mistakes happen, great plays happen too.
Right. Okay, talk to you at the end. Now let's get on with the second half action.
Early in the third quarter, John Elway finds himself in a spot of trouble. Third and 17 at Denver's 34-yard line.
Over 80,000 to sell out again at Wembley Stadium for this American football contest. Elway, long yardage situation, scrambling, throwing, has a man open, Steve Watson, and it'll be a first down at the 44 of the Rams. And there's that exceptional talent of John Elway, able to find room and buy time with his legs, and Watson took quite a hit from Johnny Johnson.
The one thing that scares you when you line up defensively against this man is that you think you have him. You've destroyed the play, you've covered the receivers, you've got pressure on him, and suddenly Elway gets out of the pocket, runs to the outside, and still maintains contact with his receivers. Watch this shot. This is the one you mentioned, Dick, right here.
It wasn't here. Johnson. It was Clifford Hicks coming over, 28, the rookie who made the initial hit, and Johnson just pushed him down.
That's a sandwich job there.
Hicks they like very much. Third-round pick. Will Hite, the man with a mile-high somersault in the old days when he celebrated a touchdown. He's off and off his feet, and Will Hite buys a couple extra yards with that dive down to the 35. It'll be second and one.
I got to tell you, if I did a dive like that, I'd break my neck. Did you see him came down right on his head and just flipped on over as if it didn't even bother him?
Almost a free down now for the Broncos, who have moved very impressively on this drive. 10.5 minutes remaining, third quarter. Broncos trail the Rams 7-6. Orson Mobley in motion, and he leads the ball carrier through a fumble, and the Rams have recovered.
No, he's down. They're going to say he's down, I think, Dick.
Apparently, laying down, Jim Collins covered the football, number 50, but Lang's knee was down at the 28-yard line. By the way, there is no instant replay. It was not yesterday in the Hall of Fame game, nor here today in London.
Let's see if Lang is indeed on the ground. There, I think that's a fumble.
Well, it looks like from that angle that it was. But again, because of the nature of this game, first week of the preseason, instant replay, while it will be in effect again this year throughout the 87 season, not used this weekend. It will be later in the preseason. Elway underneath to Mobley, the big tight end. And he's tough to bring down all the way to the 16-yard line before Vince Newsome can drag him out of bounds.
Newsome looked like a dog biting on a tire, truck tire there, just kind of bouncing along behind.
Elway sounds, it looks as if he's audibilizing, and underneath to Mobley, and Newsome having to come a long way. And
that's a mismatch.
Mobley, a giant tight end at 6'5 and 256, and Elway and the Broncos continue their march toward a possible first touchdown for Denver at the 16 of the Rams. Lang hit in the backfield by Greg Meisner, number 69. Former All-American and academic All-American at Pittsburgh.
That play designed to get outside, but Meisner with great penetration very quickly off that ball was able to catch the offside guard and drive him into the backfield and stack that whole play up.
Loss of a couple. It'll be second down and 12. Watson to the right, Vance Johnson to the left. Lang and Wilhite behind Elway. It's Wilhite on the draw, 10. He's to the 6, and that'll be close to a first down.
Well, Ahmad said this crowd was cheering in the wrong places. They seem to have responded very well to this drive by Denver. Quick acceleration, good cutting by Wilhite. He's hit hard, but he already had the first down when they nailed him.
First and goal at the 6 as the Broncos threaten to take the lead here in the third quarter. On the ground again. Lang, touchdown! The
defense of the Rams shut off the inside, but there was no one to contain outside. Gene Lang, 6 yards for the Denver score.
Just a bounce out. The play was designed to go off tackle. The Rams had it closed off. It looked like Kevin Green, the outside linebacker, got out of position. Watch the play. It's designed to go off tackle. Lang right there hits the stack and then just bounces to the outside, and nobody's home.
Lang, who scored only one touchdown rushing all of last year, had but 94 yards rushing. Rich Carlos adds the extra point. And with 8 minutes and 12 seconds remaining in the third quarter, for the first time in American Cup 87 at Wembley Stadium, the Denver Broncos are in the lead. It's 13-7. A tough two, and Ricky Hundley, 238 pounds, a linebacker, number 98 for Denver, made the stop. Here comes Hundley out.
I talked about the complexity of this Denver defense. It took Hundley a long time. Of course, he wouldn't sign with Cincinnati when he was drafted, ended up coming to the Broncos, and literally sat for about a year before he was familiar enough with this defense to play. Boy, he knows what he's doing in there now and has really become an effective inside linebacker.
Tim Terrell, 32, joining Charles White in the backfield for Los Angeles behind Dills. Over the middle, wide open is Kevin House, and he's down to the 46 of Denver with a first down. Nine yards for House, who had some big years with Tampa Bay.
It's going to take a while for Ernie Zampezi to instill the changes in this Ram offense that he wants to make, but you can feel a difference already in the passing game. You can sense a greater concentration on it, and certainly a lot more confidence in the passing game.
Dills, who preceded Elway at Stanford University at the controls, former Viking, and Jim Ryan, the outside linebacker, with a blitz and traps his prey. 3:35 remaining in the third period. On first down, Dills sacked for the second time, or at least the Rams quarterbacks suffered their second sack. A reminder to our viewers, we'll be selecting the Budweiser Most Valuable Player in today's game. We'll announce that at the conclusion. Wembley Stadium. When was it, 1966, that the British won the World Cup here, beat West Germany 3-2. Whoops, Woolen Jones, anticipating the count, will pick up 5. Jones, who set a Denver record with 13 and a half sacks last year. An All-Pro outing for him, one of the highly regarded defensive talents in the National Football League. Ernie Zampezi, we recorded that before the game. He's upstairs, of course, as the offensive coordinator. 8 years in San Diego, the Chargers number one in pass offense, 6 of the 8 under Zampezi. And he's been ticketed by the Rams to improve that aspect of their game. Charles White running through tacklers to the 31-yard line. And it doesn't matter if it's Des Moines or London, you love that kind of running. Rick Dennison finally put the stopper on him, but a first down for the Rams at the 32.
Little pat for Tom Newberry, pulling guard, who got out in front of him. Gave him some help in springing that one open. Duval Love over there to open the way, too.
Love, number 67, a tackle for Irv Pankey, who was not reported to the Rams camp. Pankey sitting out, looking for more dollars.
Ooh.
Not enough this time as Freddie Gilbert. He joined the Broncos at the start of last season out of the USFL, where he played 3 years with the New Jersey Generals, and they really like Gilbert on the outside. He's 6'4 and 275, college ball at Georgia.
They've helped him to put a lot of strength on that frame. He was not terribly strong when he arrived. He was big, and they've really beefed him up. They like him. He moved over to that left end and moved Andre Townsend inside to the nose.
Dills on first down over the middle. Terrell. He's inside the 25 to the 23, and that's the kind of quick-hitting play that Sam Pizzi brings from San Diego, and Robinson loves it. Here's his feelings.
Every organization, I think, is built on the success and the quality of the people they have. We feel we have a great addition to our staff in Ernie Zampezi, long-time great coach in the NFL. He's in charge of our passing game. He's going to be the coordinator of our offense. I'm really excited about his ability to teach, his expertise in the passing game, and the quality of man that he is. He's a great addition for us.
Robinson, obviously excited about that acquisition. They've been the most important that the Rams made in the offseason. Short yardage play, and over the top goes Charles White. As a collegian, perhaps no one any better than White in making that play, and he picks up the necessary two and another Ram first down in the final seconds of the third quarter. The Broncos scoring early in this period to take the lead 13-7, and now the Rams with a sustained drive down to the Denver 21.
Offense is asserting themselves much more efficiently here in the second half.
Yards rushing almost even.
A lot of jumping around down there too.
Yeah, it's been an amazingly clean visual account by our British and international crew from London. Dills out of the backfield to White, a perfect throw. And White is out of bounds inside the 10, and you just can't throw that pass any better than Steve Dills offered it to White on the dead run.
The Rams have been working since March to time out their passing game. It certainly is paying dividends. Boy, that ball exactly where it had to be to keep him running and in stride downfield.
End of the third quarter. John Robinson, Rams will have first and goal when we return. But first, these words from
Image, away on his own for a Rams 6-yard touchdown. The kick is good. The Rams regain the lead, 14 points to 13. As we rejoin the action, the Broncos have the ball in good field position. It's second and five at the Rams 36.
Jackson gets his feet inbounds as he dances with a first down at the 28 of the Rams. Greg Proud. Williamson, a rookie corner.
Crowd liked that one. They responded well to that one.
So Williamson, a free agent, and they're working on him. He's playing against some pretty tough wide receivers for Denver, and Denver can really throw some speed at you this year with Jackson, Vance Johnson, Ricky Natiel. I mean, those Ready. Are men that are all gravity. If he makes the squad, they were men that all run the 100, down around 9.4, 9.3 or better.
Those cornerbacks are out there all by themselves anyway, and then you see these guys come out there with the sprinter speed. I mean, you start backing up, your legs start shaking. I wouldn't want to be out there.
Both Jackson and Natiel to the left, and they run left with Sewell, and now he throws to Natiel. And he's inside the 15. Ricky Natiel, his first catch for the Broncos.
I asked Dan Reeves how much of the offense he would have in. He said, we'll only have about a week's worth. Well, that's a lot of offense for a week.
Steve Sewell. He threw the pass last year, didn't he, to Elway against
he
the Raiders
sure
in that very
touchdown.
First game of the season.
You bet. Sewell, a very versatile performer. We mentioned that they're trying to work him more and that fullback position this year, but I imagine they'll also give him a chance to come from that H-back position.
10.5 minutes remain, fourth quarter. The Broncos threaten to regain the lead. Bootleg Kubiak. End zone, Jackson, touchdown! Jackson over the middle brings back memories of Cleveland in overtime.
Sure does. Two great catches, one for a touchdown that pushed that game into overtime, a game that the Broncos were able to come back and win.
Low snap, but the kick is good, and Denver leads 20-14.
The lead changes again, but now the Rams have yet another chance. As we pick up the action, they're deep in their own territory, second and five at their own 35.
Steve Dills, a veteran in his ninth year, eludes the rush, sidearms it to Kevin House, 45-40. Down the sidelines, out of bounds at the 25, the longest play of the game. And Dills, a great job. He got away from a tough rush and sidearmed a strike to House for 39 yards.
That'll help to even up the passing yardage. Just a little crossing pattern. Dills threw traffic and had to thread that ball in there. Good job of getting the toss in there. Watch House now. He just comes across the middle. He expected the pass earlier. That's Darren Como, number 59, trying to cover him. But once House is underway, Como didn't have a chance.
Now the Rams trailing by six. Dills looking for more into the end zone, and that'll be interference against Michael Young. Lyle Pickens, a rookie from Colorado. Too much body, and that will give the Rams a big penalty.
Well, the benefit of experience. Michael Young has been there a few more times than Lyle Pickens, and he knew how to get the youngster to bump him. That's interference in the end zone. They'll move it down to the 1 yard line.
Now the fans at that end of the stadium with a chance to see four shots from the 1 yard line. Here it is again. Pickens looking back for the ball, and Young, a wise veteran, slowing down, and Pickens could not elude the contact.
You saw the way Young started to raise his hands as if he was going for the ball, and Pickens bumped him at that point.
Tim Terrell, touchdown, and the Rams tie it at 20. Terrell from Northern Illinois, free agent pick from the Falcons in 84, and he made the Rams as a special teamer. Good blocker, one of those guys that overachiever that just plays hard for you no matter where you use him.
A little airborne here. Terrell, who does most of his work on special teams, shows you he knows how to fly.
20-20, Lasher's try for a point is good. Well, I must say, and this isn't just to try to sell this game, but for the first preseason game, this second half, no turnovers, the offensive action has been quite remarkable.
Very few penalties, and we've had an awful lot of substitutions. I think it's the kind of game that both coaches are going to end up being very pleased with.
So in three plays, the Rams go 70 yards with a penalty. It took them only 53 seconds. And they take the lead 21-20 with plenty of time remaining, 6 minutes and 13 seconds. So a quiet first half, 7-6 at the intermission, the Rams leading. And we've had two touchdowns apiece here in the second. High but short to Lang at the 14. And he's out to the 31-yard line. Terrell, who just scored the touchdown, in on that tackle, along with Norwood Van.
I think they may have singled him out and looked for him on this one. They said, hey, that's the guy who scored a touchdown. Let's see if we can put a helmet on him. He's the first one down. Look how he breaks down there.
Ooh. Oh, my
hello.
Goodness.
Oh, my. Are you the guy who scored that touchdown? Wow.
Oh, my. 31-yard line. Kubiak back at quarterback for Denver. Now you have a sense that each coach wants to come away with a win. Orson Mobley in this wide open second half, and the tight end all the way to the 46-yard line. Ed Zeman, a rookie, made the tackle. 22 yards for Mobley.
Zeman, a fun story. Had a tryout last year with Chicago. Played here with the Bears last year. His father, Bob Zeman, coach for the Broncos at one time, for also for the Los Angeles Raiders.
Played for the Chargers, a defensive back. Mobley, who had been nicked earlier in the week, shaken on that last catch.
Well, the one thing you don't want in these early games, and certainly in this one, is injuries. And this game has been relatively injury-free.
Nateel split to the bottom of the screen. Steve Sewell inside the 45, a gain of nearly five. Donald Evans, the Rams' top pick, in on that stop, number 64. He's from Raleigh, North Carolina. So the Broncos going with basically a unit that looks with a lot of first teamers in there. Sports world to follow. Championship junior lightweight bout from Windsor, England. And you'll learn who this year will carry the title, NFL's fastest man. Gerald Wilhite with Sewell behind Kubiak. Going deep. Nateel. Touchdown. Stolen away. The Rams have it. Clifford Hicks, 15-20, and he's out to the 21. In a battle of outstanding rookies, Clifford Hicks took it right out of the paws of Nateel. What a play.
Two rookies responding instinctively as they race downfield. Watch this ball drop in over the shoulder of Hicks. And he plays it like a wide receiver. The best defensive backs think they own that football. And Hicks showing a little class there and then getting upfield and doing a good job of running that back for some extra yardage.
From our angle and from that camera angle, it looked as if it was Nateel who had slipped behind to make the catch. But Hicks, and if you're going to give an award, and we are, he has to be in the running for the Budweiser player of this game. He's done everything well, the rookie from Oregon, and that's exactly what a coach wants, a rookie to come forth and show his mettle. So the Rams leading 21-20 with 4.5 minutes left, and Charles White smothered after a 2-3-yard gain.
Well, the Rams were not given high marks by many of the national publications for their draft, but Hicks is one of the bright spots. Donald Evans, whom they expect to come in and give them some help as a pass rusher, was very late coming to camp. In fact, got his first work over here during this week, and they have yet to evaluate his talent properly. But Clifford Hicks certainly will get high marks for what he has done this evening.
Terrell and White behind Steve Dills. Dills throwing to Terrell, incomplete out at the 45. A little swing pattern, and Bruce Klosterman.
I tried to get Klosterman to trade jerseys here a little while ago. Put him on the other side. Duke Shamel said, hey, that's not me.
There'll be a lot of that going on in all of the calls this preseason. There are only 160-plus in uniform today.
It's exciting, I'll tell you, to look down there and try and sort them all out.
Just think, these coaches have to go back after the long ride home, break down the film, study just how well these new faces did perform. Third down and 7 for the Rams. Dills over the middle, incomplete to Chuck Scott, their number 2 pick of 85 from Vanderbilt. And so, with no time consumed, 3:42 left, the Rams have to give it back by way of the punt to Denver.
One of the interesting things about this game is both these teams have to get on the plane and go home. And that's a long flight after this ball game. They'll both fly back home tonight.
Denver, however, doesn't play till next weekend. Game in Arizona, and the Rams have to come back, play at home at Anaheim Stadium on Thursday night. High kick by Bowman. Nateel. The crowd building with anticipation as Nateel, those wheels spinning as he received and returned to the 45. A 5-yard return, 37-yard kick, and Denver, good field position at its 45.
One of the things that Broncos are hoping is that the heat wave that had a hold of Colorado when they left is going to be broken when they get back. They'd had the hottest weather in over 100 years, 95 plus, pushing up toward 100 degrees. They were glad to come over here. It's very cool over here.
There's Hicks, who took one away from Nateel. I thought you were going to give Ricky Nateel the nickname Heat Wave. That wouldn't be too bad. Kubiak down the middle, incomplete. Leaping try by Nateel. I talked with him a couple days ago at Crystal Palace, where the two teams were working out, and learned that he had never seen an NFL game in person. He's playing in the first that he's ever seen. And I said, well, what do you like to do? He said, well, I like kids. I have my degree in counseling. He works rehabbing juvenile delinquents and drug problems, and he said, I just love kids. What a great answer. Nateel, number one pick of Denver. Time remaining, fourth quarter. Denver down by one. And they're not that far. A couple of first downs from field goal range. Well, Dan Reeves, of all the people that'll praise Ricky Nateel, he's the one who has most at stake.
Well, Ricky Nateel has been probably the most exciting rookie that we've had in our training camp this year. He's caught a touchdown pass in every scrimmage that we've had. He's been impressive in every drill that we've had. I think he's going to be certainly an impact player, and we're interested also to see what he does on kickoff and punt returns.
Nateel, he's a package of power at 5'9 and 180. 2:45 left in the fourth. Denver trails the Rams by one. Kubiak, is it good? Yes, complete to Nateel at the 35-yard line. Ed Zeman on the coverage.
And I think that's what Dan Reeves was talking about.
He has so much speed deep, you have to respect that. And then he just breaks his pattern underneath and is wide open for Kubiak. And a good job sensing the sidelines.
I think one of the advantages of a player coming out of a program, he came out of Florida, they throw the ball, they run a pro system. He's not an inexperienced receiver. It's as if he had been trained for this kind of setup.
2:38 left in the final period. Gerald Wilhite up the middle. And number 99, Alvin Wright, 265-pounder, makes the tackle after a 3-yard pickup. And that'll probably take us down to the 2-minute warning. And the Broncos, already in long field goal range, would like to pick up 10, 15 yards more, and a field goal could win it for them.
Dick, I can't remember watching a first preseason game, an early game, and this is a week earlier than most of the games that ordinarily open the season, with fewer penalties and one turnover in the whole game.
2 minutes remaining, and one of the goals of the NFL this year was to tighten up the games, make the games play within a 3-hour period, and they have accomplished that. This game ran 3.5 hours last year, and it looks as if it'll finish well under the 3-hour mark tonight at Wembley, unless we have overtime.
And we're glad we're not in Canada. They might still get a rouge and tie this one up and go to overtime.
21-20, the Rams with Denver with the ball. Kubiak trying to strike down the middle to Nateel. Touchdown! Teal's fifth catch of the game, a 32-yard touchdown, and Denver is back in front 26-21 with 1:53 left. Did they score too soon?
Well, Dan Reeves said that Nateel had caught a touchdown pass in every scrimmage that they had had. Well, he's added one in his first game as an NFLer, and an impressive one at that.
A regular kicker, Rich Carlos, to try the extra point. Good. Well, this crowd of over 80,000 at Wembley Stadium thoroughly entertained. And the Broncos now on the lead, 27-21. The rookie Nateel's presence felt. And the Broncos now to kick to the Rams, and we'll see how John Robinson plays it, how far he goes toward that first team. See if he can rally.
No one's going to sleep yet.
Wagner's kick is short. That was 38 John Embry, a tight end from Colorado, who returned it. Charles White, he has a long way to go to score, and hits it all the way inside the 20-yard line. Beautifully executed screen, and the quality, the high level of play in this second half continues. It has been an offensive show for these fans in England.
Charles White, who ran so effectively at the beginning of this second half, takes this little screen pass to the outside, gets some good blocking. Tom Newberry, 66, one of the blockers, sidesteps, gets away from Braxton, and then steps out of bounds to kill the clock.
He's down to the 18-yard line. We've got just a few minutes on the clock, a minute 36 seconds on the clock.
Kevin House to the 11-yard line, short yardage. We presume the Rams have at least two of their timeouts remaining. The access to the game statistics is not as readily available as we would have in an NFL stadium, as you might well imagine. The ball just outside the 10. Clock ticking at 110-109. The Rams trailing 27-21. A touchdown, an extra point could win it. White, draw play. Nothing there except orange, and they crush White. Steve Wilson, valuable veteran, number 45, last to get up off the pile. Clock stop, timeout Rams with 50 seconds remaining. Coach Collier and the Bronco defense trying to find the right answers on first and goal. White. And wisely, the veteran using the sidelines. No gain. Randy Robbins made the defensive play. It is second and goal with 45 seconds left. Rick Dennison calling the defensive signals from Colorado State.
One of the things you worry about when you bring teams over this early in the year is they're not going to be ready to play, but these teams were certainly ready for this one this evening. More than ready.
Dills over the middle to Terrell. Incomplete. He did not have possession. A scramble on the goal line. Lyle, or Tyrone Braxton saying he has the ball, which he may well have, but was ruled incomplete, and the clock stopped with 40 seconds. So entertaining to the final seconds. This American Bowl 87. A nice way to start our year as the late dusk of English Sunday. Rained a couple hours before the game. What's new there? It's been a very damp summer for the British. For the fans, it's nice to say thank you to these British fans, and they have received that from these two teams. Third and goal, Dills. Incomplete, but a flag is down at the goal line, and we may have had a penalty against the Broncos.
Of course, that penalty would carry.
If it's holding, it carries the first down, and nothing could be better for the Rams, because without the penalty, it would have been fourth and goal.
A holding call against the Denver defense. Kevin House, number 83.
Kevin Clark is 27, a rookie from San Jose State.
Realized he was going to get away from him and just put the clamps on him. There you see the flag coming in after the fact, but it's a first down call on the 4-yard line. Play coming in. Zampezi, of course, upstairs in the coach's box, phoning those plays down to the sideline, and they're messengered in.
Half the distance of the goal line, a 4-yard penalty, and four downs go with it. 34 seconds remain.
I'm impressed with what both these second-team quarterbacks, Dills and Kubiak, have done in this second half.
Kevin House and Michael Young to the left. They run the other way to Charles White. Touchdown, Los Angeles. You think they'll sell tickets next year for this one?
I think everyone on the Denver side of the line expecting the ball to be in the air, but Ernie Zampezi crossed them up. They handed the ball to Charles White, and Charles, who's had a fantastic second half here, continues to show us what he can do with it.
And now Lansford, the top kicker for the Rams, who has been back and forth across the pond all week, tries to win it for the Rams.
And if he misses, well, let's not think about that.
Lansford barefoots it through. 28-27 Los Angeles. Denver has 28 seconds to get in field goal range. low kick into the wedge of the Broncos out to the 34-yard line. Comes Mike Freeman. He's fielded two kickoffs in this game. That may be at least a British record. Bartlett, a rookie linebacker, makes the tackle, 26 seconds showing. And the Broncos, with all that speed at wide receiver, who's to say they can't get in field goal range, and they have one timeout to spend.
Which team was it that nicknamed their wide formation with three receivers on the outside, Big Ben? And maybe that's what we'll see here, and how appropriate to finish up with that.
Nateel to the right.
No, we're not going to see it yet.
Gary Roll, another rookie, is split left. Dubiak, a flag down, goes to Nateel, complete if it counts. And they say the clock's running, but it stops now with the penalty flag and 19 seconds showing. Greg Williamson, cornerback rookie for the Rams, made the play, and the penalty is against Denver.
Defensive coordinator for the Rams, Dan Remsburg, up a little quickly. I was going to say that Fritz Schirmer, the defensive coordinator for the Rams, has had his hands full over on the far side during this evening. There's Remsburg. They're pleased with his progress during this training camp.
Sports World with the NFL's fastest man and the junior lightweight championship bout from nearby Windsor. And this has been a dandy scrap at Wembley. 28-27 Rams. Kubiak looking for something special, chased by Doss, and his pass incomplete, looking for Nateel coming back on the sidelines. Well, we can award our most valuable player award, sponsored by Budweiser, and it goes to the veteran from the University of Southern California, the former number one pick of the Cleveland Browns, Charles White. White with nearly 100 yards in rushing and receiving, couple of touchdowns, is our winner from Wembley. Budweiser will donate $1,000 to the United Way on behalf of Charles White. Triple left formation.
Here's Big Ben.
Kubiak goes the other way to Kay. Tried the one-handed catch at the 50-yard line.
Been around 7 years. Many had counted him out after he was traded from Cleveland, but he's put a few of those doubts behind him. I think he's a little pumped up too.
Great athlete, San Fernando High School in California. Kubiak,
there it is, hang it up.
Last play of the game, incomplete, and this game is over. American Bowl 87 won by the Rams, 28-27. They loved it in London.
John Smith got the right result, but with the wrong strategy. Not a defensive game, John.
That's right. It became an offensive showpiece. Both teams came out running the ball in the third quarter. Then they opened it up in the air in the fourth quarter. It was a very exciting game. I'm amazed at the efficiency of the offense this early.
Two rookies stood out for me. Ricky Nateel for Denver, Clifford Hicks for the Rams.
Well, both of them really show that they can play in this league. Both of them should, because they're what we call blue chippers, a first-round pick and a third-round pick. But Clifford's going to have a hard time because both the Rams cornerbacks are all pros. So he won't start straight away, but you'll see him probably running back kicks, punt returns, kickoff returns. But Nateel, unbelievable speed. 4.3 seconds in the 40, and you could see it out there, blazing speed and good hands.
The players wanted to win. The crowd responded to it. It was a very competitive game.
It was. It was great to see a pro, White, Charles White, number 33, come out and really prove himself, because he's behind Dickerson. He was a Heisman Trophy winner, cut by the Browns in 1983, set out the season. The Browns cut him the following season. The Rams picked him up off the scrap heap, and he had a great game.
John, thanks very much. Well, today's been a mouth-watering taste of what should be an exciting season, particularly for us here on Channel 4. We return with a special preview program on September the 13th, and from then on, for the first time, we'll be having two American football programs every week. There'll be one show in the usual slot on Sundays at 6 o'clock, and then an added program late on Tuesday night at 10 o'clock, featuring the extended highlights of a game within 48 hours of it happening. And our first Tuesday, on September the 15th, we'll have the game between the last two Super Bowl champions, the New York Giants against the Chicago Bears, just 24 hours after the game takes place on Soldier Field. Also on four, throughout October, a treat for baseball fans. 10 programs featuring the playoffs and the World Series. It's going to be an exhilarating time for us all. I hope you'll be able to join us from an excited Wembley. Goodbye.